हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल गुरुमंत्र शिक्षा का ग्रंथ। आई एम योर एजुकेटर निधि दुआ एंड आई वार्मली वेलकम्स यू एट दिस प्लेटफॉर्म। सो गाइस, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव स्टार्टेड आर ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। वी हैव कवर्ड टू पार्ट्स फॉर द टॉपिक आइसोमेरिज्म एंड दिस इज आर लास्ट पार्ट रिलेटेड टू आइसोमेरिज्म। ओके, and with isomerism in today's lecture we will start our reaction mechanism part, which is very important. Okay, so without any further delay, let's begin our today's topic. So in previous lecture we have started EZ system. So what is EZ system? We have covered this. Now if you have given any alkene and in that particular alkene, when higher priority groups are attached to opposite side, then this system will be named as E system. Okay, as you can see here in example 1, higher priority group, HP is your higher priority group and LP is your lower priority group. Higher priority groups are attached from opposite side, then this system is E side. And if both the higher priority groups are attached to the same side, then this system will be named as Z system. Okay. Now the priority rules. Rule number one says priority is proportional to the atomic number of atom. Okay. Which is directly attached to the carbon. Rule second is, if rule one is failed, then consider the next atom, which means if two similar same kinds of atoms are attached to the carbon atom, then you have to see the next atom. Okay. Third rule says, if isotopes are given to you, if isotopes are attached to the carbon atom, then you have to set the priorities. You have to give the number one higher priority to the that isotope which has the maximum atomic mass. Okay, these are the three rules to set the priority. Now example, as you can see here in example one, higher priority group is the chlorine. Why? Because chlorine has the maximum atomic number as compared to carbon. So both the higher priority groups are attached to the carbon atom from same side. That's mean this system is your Z system. And when the two higher priority groups are attached from the different sides, from opposite side, then this system will be your E system. Okay. Now a very important topic, that is number of geometrical isomers in polyenes. You can get questions related to this topic. Question can be asked in the exam. Okay, related to this topic. Now, as you can see here, a carbon chain is given to you. Okay. In this carbon chain, as you can see here, R1 and R2 are the two alkyl groups. If you want to calculate the number of geometrical isomers in that particular alkene chain, what you have to do? First of all, you have to see that the first member, the alkyl chain, the alkyl group R1 and R2, the ending member of that particular alkene chain is equal or unequal. If these two R1 and R2 are unequal, then the number of GI possible, then the number of geometrical isomers possible will be equals to the 2 to the power n. This is the formula to calculate the geometrical isomers if starting member and the ending member of a particular alkene chains are unequal. Okay, what is n? N is the number of double bond present in a carbon chain. Okay, this is the example related to this formula. As you can see here, R1 is your CH3 while R2 is your ethyl group CH3CH2, which means R1 is not equals to R2. That's mean if we want to calculate the number of GI, the formula will be 2 to the power n, and n is your number of double bonds. As you can see here, number of double bonds are 1, 2 and 3, which means 2 to the power 3 and 2 to the power 3 is your 8. So, the number of geometrical isomers in this particular chain is 8. Next, if R1 is equals to R2, if the starting member and the ending member, the last member of a carbon chain are equal, if two alkyl groups are equal, then the number of GI will be equals to 2 to the power N minus 1 plus 2 to the power P minus 1, where P is equals to N by 2. What is N? The number of double bonds. When N is even, if number of double bonds present in a carbon chain is even, then P will be equals to N by 2, and if N is odd, then the P value of P will be equals to N plus 1 by 2. Okay, this is the example related to this formula. As you can see here, N is equals to 3, 1, 2 and 3. 3 means odd number of double bonds are present. That's why we have chosen the formula P is equals to N plus 1 by 2. And we will put this formula into this formula and we will get the answer as 6. Which means for this series, 6 geometrical isomers are present. Okay. Now, our second part, which is reaction mechanism. Guys, this is very important topic related to the organic chemistry. First of all, we need to understand that what is a reaction. As you know it very well, when a reaction takes place in nature, then the breaking of old covalent bond takes place and the formation of new bonds takes place. Okay, this is the meaning of reaction. While what is the meaning of mechanism? Mechanism means steps. And reaction mechanism is the step-by-step description of a reaction. Okay. Now, the concepts to understand the reaction mechanism. To understand the concept of reaction mechanism, there are three major points. Number one is electronic transfer of electrons. Second is nature of functional reagents. And third one is types of reaction. We will discuss these three points step by step. So number one is electronic transfer of electron. The transfer of electrons majorly depends on the four factors, or you can say majorly depends on the four effects. These four effects are inductive effect, second is electromeric effect, third is resonance or mesomeric effect, and fourth one is hyperconjugation effect. In today's lecture, we will discuss number one effect, that is inductive effect. Okay, so what is inductive effect? In chemistry, the inductive effect is an effect regarding the transmission of unequal sharing of bonding electrons through a chain of atom in a molecule, leading to a permanent dipole in a bond. Or you can say to attain electron or to repel electron of a covalent bond is called inductive effect. Okay, so this inductive effect can be of two types. Number one is your minus I effect and number two is your plus I effect. Okay, if you have given a compound like this CH3Z and the electronegativity of that particular element, that particular atom Z, is greater than that of the carbon atom, then this compound will be known as minus I effect, or you can say this Z atom will behave as a minus I group. Okay. And if the electronegativity of carbon atom is greater than that of the Z atom, then the Z atom will be known as plus I group. On that basis, we have two type of I inductive effect or I effect, that is minus I effect and plus I effect. Okay. Now, as you can see here, this is the very important order of minus I groups. These all functional groups are regarding as minus I groups. You have to learn these orders, okay? They will help you to solve different question related to the organic chemistry, related to the stability orders of different carbocations, carbenions, acidic orders, and for the stability of carbonyl compounds also. Okay, so you have to remember these two orders. Number one is for minus I group and number two is for plus I group. Okay guys, now applications of I effect. If you talk about the application of I effect, number one is the stability of carbocation. First of all, what is carbocation? A carbocation is a molecule in which a carbon atom has positive charge and three bonds. Okay, we can basically say that there are carbon cations, or you can say carbocations. Okay, formerly they were known as carbonium ion and today known as carbocations. Carbocations are represented by this symbol C+. If you talk about the stability order of carbocation, this is directly proportional to plus I and inversely proportional to the minus I group. Okay, as you can see here, this is an example related to the stability of carbocation. In this example, you have to tell the stability of carbocation. So first of all, you have to check the groups that are attached to the carbon chain. As you can see here, in these three compounds, all the functional groups are from minus I groups. As you can see here, NO2, CN and CHO. These are the minus I groups, but the stability of carbocations are inversely proportional to the minus I group, which means the group which has maximum minus I group will have the minimum stability of carbocation. That's why, as you can see here, NO2 has the maximum minus I group. That's why the stability order of this carbocation is minimum. Okay, and CHO group has the minimum minus I group. That's why the stability of this carbocation is maximum. Okay, second application is for the stability of carb anion. Okay, now what is carb anion? Carb anion is an anion which carbon has unshared pair of electron and bears a negative charge, usually with three substituent of a total of 8 valence electron. And if you talk about the stability order of carb anion, this is directly proportional to minus I effect and inversely proportional to the plus I effect. Third application is for reactivity of carbonyl compounds. What are carbonyl compounds? Carbonyl compounds includes your aldehyde group and ketonic groups, okay, which is also directly proportional to the minus I effect and inversely proportional to the plus I effect. And you have to remember this, the characteristic reaction of carbonyl compounds is nucleophilic addition reaction. We will discuss the types of reaction in the further lectures. Okay, now fourth is your acidic strength. Acidic strength is directly proportional to minus I effect and inversely proportional to the plus I effect. If you want to find the acidic strength of different compounds, what you have to do, number one step is make an intermediate anion. Okay, when you make the intermediate anion, see the stability of anion, which means you have to see the stability of carb anion. If the stability of carb anion is more, that means the corresponding acid is also more acidic. Okay, these are the steps related to the to find the acidic strength of a particular compound. Okay guys, now in case if you are new here at our YouTube channel, you can like, share and subscribe. For further query, you can mail us on tanejanehaofficial@gmail.com and also you can contact us on the given number. Now a very important announcement, if you are preparing for CSIR UGC NET, you can follow Neha Taneja ma'am on Unacademy platform. On Unacademy platform, you will get daily life classes, structural courses, live test and quizzes, and with one subscription, you will get unlimited access. If you are interested, you can go through with this detailed paid classes. While taking these detailed paid classes, you can use referral code NEHA, that is NEHA. And after using this referral code, you will get 10% discount on total fee. Thank you very much, guys. I hope now you all are cleared about the topic inductive effect.